Hey, it's Isabel from thedietsolutionprogram.com. And today I'm going to tell you something very, very shocking, and that is that saturated fat is not the cause of heart disease. I know, you think I'm crazy because your doctor told you to stay away from anything with saturated fat. But I'm here to give you some facts that will show you how it's not the saturated fat that's causing all this heart disease, but it is the packaged, processed, sugar, refined foods that everyone is eating that is really causing an increased percentage in heart disease in our country today. So the simple fact is that before 1920, the incidence of heart disease was very, very low. And not until about 1950 did we see this increased rate of heart disease. I mean, I think the percentage now is heart disease kills 40% of the population. And that actually must be an old statistic. I'm pretty sure that it's a lot higher than 40% right now. So what happened between 1920 and 1950 that caused this increase in heart disease? Now, if the truth is that saturated fat is what's causing heart disease, we would assume that people now eat more saturated fat during that time. But actually, I have some interesting facts that came straight out of Sally Fallon's great book, Nourishing Traditions. And this is what she writes. During the 60-year period from 1910 to 1970, the proportion of traditional animal fat in the American diet declined from 83% to 62%. So actually, the consumption of saturated fat went down, and butter consumption plummeted from 18 pounds per person each year to 4 pounds per person each year. So actually, people were eating a significantly less amount of butter during that time. Interesting. During the past 80 years, the consumption of dietary cholesterol intake has increased by only 1%. So if this is true, and actually people are eating less saturated fat, they're eating less butter, and they're not eating very much more cholesterol, how could that be the cause of this increased heart disease? Well, Sally Fallon also writes this. During the same period, the average intake of dietary vegetable oils in the form of margarine, shortening, and refined oils increased by 400%. This is significant. Once we started eating these refined oils, the incidence of heart disease drastically increased. She also says the consumption of sugar and processed foods increased by 60%. And I truly believe this is only one piece of the research. People are eating way too many processed fake foods, tons of processed carbohydrates, tons of sugar, and even in my own practice, when I decrease these foods, people become much, much healthier. So taking these facts into account, it is not the saturated fat. It's not the healthy, organic, raw butter that you can cook with that's causing heart disease. It's not the unrefined organic coconut oil. It's not the natural grass-fed beef. These things are okay. And it's not the egg yolk that's giving you high cholesterol. It's these processed foods, it's cakes, it's cookies, it's tons of pasta, tons of bread that's causing the incidence of disease. To find out more information on how to take back your health and put together your own healthy meal plans, visit my website, thedietsolutionprogram.com today.